Konnichiwa, minasan. Z here of Magic Dream Creations with Mr. Manager Orgy.
Hi, guys.
And we've got a special guest with us, a mastermind of RattlesTV and the owner of Lancery Armory. Valence, say hi. You're not going to say hi. You're evil.
Why would I say hi?
Difficult. Anyway, all three of us are here because we went to see Warcraft, the movie.
Woo-woo.
And, well, all three of us are players of the game, so we got to ask... answer the epic all-time everybody asks this question, Horde or Alliance? So
Horde. Don't care.
You're neutral on that one?
I like playing characters.
If you had to have a preference, which one would you play?
No.
Just no.
Because I play both.
You play both sides?
Yeah.
Pretty equally.
Pretty much I have characters on both sides.
Yeah, I prefer Horde.
I was like, honestly, I don't like the Horde capital at all.
Orgrimmar?
Yeah,
neither does Orgy can vouch with you on that one.
Yeah,
he prefers
like
Undercity.
Yep, I prefer Undercity.
Okay.
I like the Undead Temple.
Whereas
it's awesome.
I'm the weird one. I like Orgrimmar. But
it's like I guess it's because I actually understand Stormwind,
Ironforge.
Stormwind and Ironforge. I don't like Ironforge that much, but I like Stormwind just because it's a castle. I like castles.
It's huge.
Fuck Stormwind.
I didn't like Stormwind. Even trying to storm Stormwind was a pain in the ass.
Yep.
But so yeah, we all play World of Warcraft. Because there is a difference, guys.
Yes,
I don't know
this
difference. Okay, and then you got the RTS, which the movie is based upon. I have not played it, but these two gentlemen have.
Yes.
Religiously.
I was like, I've played it to the ground. I'd still play Frozen Throne every once in a while. And actually, like, one particular game setting in general, but it's bugs. Like, bug evolution, but hardly anyone plays it anymore, but it was fun.
Yeah.
So. I played the first one. I haven't played this... The second and the third.
Or the expansions. I've played them all and I still have them.
It was a lot of fun.
Rare gems, sir. It's very hard to find those Warcraft games. I want to play them because I've played Command & Conquer, so I mean it's like real-time strategy, same thing. I just never really... I didn't know there was something before World of Warcraft, so...
Yep.
I never got to play them. I got thrown into World of Warcraft. But... Not
I didn't have a computer that could run World of Warcraft, nor did I have internet. I had to go to a place here in Midland that was a LAN party
place. Yeah, I think I know which place you're talking about. I've been there a couple of times.
The game room? Yeah, it wasn't really far from here.
Yeah.
Way back when. Over there where the Domino's is.
Yeah.
I would go there and eat ramen and play Halo. All the time.
Memories. I'd go over there and get on Gaia Online because I'm that much of a dork. I didn't really have a thing to be able to play any other games with it, so I just went there with friends and I played.
Yeah, everyone
Gaia.
That was there was always playing World of Warcraft. I'm like, what is that?
Yeah. But anyway, so we're talking the Warcraft movie in itself, which is basically Warcraft, the first one, which is orcs versus humans. So, I'm fangirling so bad, guys. It's not even joking. I mean, poor Lance was sitting on the right of me, and Orgy was sitting on the left of me, and I'm doing this fangirl, trying so hard not to squee, and I'm waving my arms and going, "Oh my god!" Poor guys, flipping out. I fangirled all over the place. But so we know my opinion of the movie.
Sploosh.
Sploosh. I had nerdgasms everywhere.
It was a really well done movie.
Did you like it?
Yes.
I liked it.
Was it everything that you expected out of it?
Actually, it was better than I was expecting, to be perfectly honest. I was actually expecting utter crap.
Yeah, me too.
From the previews, it did not give the actual movie justice.
Mm-mm.
Which sometimes that plays out to be a good thing, though.
Yeah, but...
In this case, yeah, it did.
And the fun thing is we couldn't help ourselves. We've been talking in and out, like, traveling back to the house and... Just sitting around, we've been talking about differences and everything, and we found out Garona is actually, lore-wise, through the game, she is half orc, half Draenei.
Right.
But in the movie, dun dun dun, we are so going to give you guys spoilers. We're sorry. So if you haven't seen this, stop this now and go watch the movie.
Spoiler alert! Yeah.
All over the place.
All over.
In the movie, she is half orc, half human, so they changed that up a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Not only that, it was hinted at, and Valance pointed this out to me, and I had to go dig in research that she was Medivh's daughter.
Yeah, because it was pointed out, and she got the whole gift, whatever the fuck that was. It was a magic
rose
thing. And the next thing you know, she's at Stormwind and talking to the dude in the fucking cage.
Lothar.
Yeah. And I was like, Valance, and she was all dressed up like a fucking princess. I'm like, really? Okay.
Valance is very terrible with names, such as Orgy is too, so I may be filling in names here because I'm a lore nut. But, and it was hinted in the movie she was his daughter, and in the novelization of it, she is his daughter. So, there you go. Very interesting twist on that one.
Yeah, oh yeah. Very interesting.
The other difference was Medivh wasn't possessed by a demon, like they said in the movie. He was possessed by the Dark Titan.
Yes.
Well, they didn't really ever say demon.
No, they did say demon.
They said that there,
there was a demon, but they never actually said that Well, he's like, we had to go kill a demon, yeah.
Khadgar.
That was the only time it was ever really even referenced.
Yeah. So they were calling it a demon rather than it being the Dark Titan.
Well, is a demon?
Yeah. True. This is true.
Technically, the Draenei in fucking WoW, they call them demons.
They're space goats.
Space goats.
Yeah. Coast to coast.
But that's what, people call them, or space goats.
Yeah. That's the only way you could really describe Draenei's.
They were on a spaceship, and they crashed, and they look like goats. Even though they look like what I would consider what a demon would look like.
And they show up at the very beginning of the movie.
And you only see them for like a brief.
Yeah, brief.
Well, you see that one person.
The Chica.
Yeah.
And speaking in their native tongue I really liked that, though, that they had the different languages as it was for the whole game.
Yeah.
Because each sect had their own languages, and the fact that the humans couldn't understand the orcs, and the orcs couldn't understand the humans, and you had to have Corona there translating was fucking awesome.
That is epic.
I was actually
thinking at one point in the movie, I was like, do they all speak English? Because I'm about to get upset. And then they fixed that. I'm like, oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
They gave very little. If you don't like watching and reading, it's got very little subtitles.
Yeah.
Very little.
Oh, yeah. Now, it was really a lot of the Easter eggs that you can catch. Because there's a freaking summoning stone where you would go and you'd summon all your people there. I can't quite remember where that would have been located at. Somewhere in the Elwynn Forest, so I don't know. Then you had the Murloc, which everybody in the theater just cracked up laughing at that part.
Because
we were like, oh god, the Murlocs.
We're just sitting there going, it's going to do the noise. It's going to, there it goes.
Yep.
And there was a Wilhelm scream in the movie, so I'm happy.
Yes, there was. And,
if you don't know what the Wilhelm scream is, you don't know nothing.
Then you have the howls, the Luktar Ogar, victory or death. You know, they would get that. Oh god, this fan service everywhere. It was pretty awesome. And there's a lot of the ones that if you didn't catch, you weren't for sure. And me and Rhett are pretty solid on this one. That whenever the king is looking at this horse and looking to this woman, and he goes, take care of him.
Mm-hmm.
We're pretty spot on that that's Arthas.
Mm-hmm.
And that's his mother, It was like, what? And then, of course, you had
because she's holding something
child.
Wrapped up.
Mm-hmm.
A child wrapped up.
As she's going through the portal to Stormwind. And, there's just so much lore and things that you're like, yeah.
But if you're like someone like me who just likes to enjoy a movie, it's very enjoyable.
Mm-hmm. It is very enjoyable.
Mm-hmm.
And I still stick by my words. If this all wouldn't have started if Alliance would not touch shit.
Because they do. They touch everything.
At the very beginning opening, Alliance has to touch shit. Then Khadgar, don't touch anything. What the fuck does he do? Every book in the goddamn thing he touches.
Now, I really like that because they showed how the Deadwind Pass and everything became like desolate and destroyed.
Yes.
And how it is in the game, because
Yeah,
that's sexy. Because it wasn't really talked about in the game of how that happened, and then they show it in the movie, and I'm like, oh, well, that's cool. And I don't know if they showed it in the RTS, because I'd never played them, so.
I was like, well, they talk about it in WoW, how the orcs that had come to that world.
Yeah. Well, they never gave much into Karazhan. I mean, and it was a raid, and you didn't really get to go up there until you were, like, level 70, so.
Yeah, I never made it that far.
Oh. Many, many days of Karazhan. Fuck the curator. That's all I can say.
I think the highest I ever got in WoW was 40.
Oh, you've missed so much.
But I was also in Korea, and all my friends were, you know, 12, 13 hours behind me, so, yeah.
Yeah, very hard to get a raid going when you're, like,
that far behind. Well, not only that, I would join, like, Toby. And yeah, that didn't work. My signal was horrible because I'm connected to someone on the other side of the world.
Yeah.
Quite the opposite side of the world.
Aw. Sad panda. But now y'all guys can get your geeks on, and I'm going to probably just listen here because I don't know a whole bunch about it. Were there a whole lot of differences between the RTS lore and Warcraft the movie?
You're asking people that didn't really pay attention to the lore that much.
Yeah, we pretty much played the game. It was
just to play
the... there was a little bit, I remember, but it was all text.
Yeah, and it's just like...
There wasn't a whole lot of...
Like, you can remember, like, the way characters kind of looked and, like, what was going on, but you didn't really pay attention to what... Especially, that was a long time
ago. Especially if you're getting your ass handed to you. You're not paying much of attention. You're just wanting to
survive.
It's
like, I need to send out more orcs.
Yeah. Or you got to send out siege weapons with it.
Yeah, which there was no siege weapons in the movie, but the orcs were... I do like what they did to essentially counteract the fact of the matter that I was going to be kind of like, alright, how are humans going to fight something, well, four times their size almost?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I was just like, and they pointed out, it's like, don't try to overpower them, try to outmaneuver them. I'm like, yeah, see, there you go. I'm so glad they pointed that out.
They had actual strategy to it.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, when an orc did hit a human, it was insta-death, because usually they were smashing their faces in.
Yeah.
Like, pretty much literally. 90% of the time, their faces were getting hit and smashed.
Or shields caved around their face.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then there was essentially... There was one buggy-ass scene in the entire movie, and it was towards the end, as one of the orcs chokes a human, and his hand goes through his body and goes out of his body, and it's very... It literally looks glitchy like the game.
The game, yeah.
And I was just like...
Don't know if they did that on purpose or if that was a oops.
I know, because it was like the one thing that I was just like... They kept that in, and it was very obvious. It wasn't like, oh, no. I mean, there was a couple of things where I was like, you could tell here and there, but other than that, it was just that one instant where they stopped it and did it slowly, and I was like, when they could have just got his, like, middle finger and his thumb, he went, because of how big their hands were.
Oh, yeah.
There was, like, their torso was their size of, their hand was the size of a human torso, almost. On some of them. Some of them, not so much. Like Hammerhand, or Hammer Fist, or whatever the fuck his name is.
Doomhammer, I think.
Blackhand?
Blackhand.
No. Doomhammer.
Doomhammer.
Doomhammer had huge hands.
Oh, yeah.
So did Durotan.
Yeah. All the orcs are really big, and Durotan's actually considered one of the smaller ones. Always has been. And then you have, later on with Thrall, their child, which, okay, in the movie his name's Goel, because that was his birth name.
Right.
He didn't get the name Thrall until he was in the camp by Blackmoor.
Yeah,
the internment camp. That human gave him that name. But, you know, they were all considered, they were huge, but, you know, as they were brought into Azeroth or the portal and all that, most of them became green because of the fell,
mm-hmm.
because of the curse, and that doesn't get talked about till way later, and I'm sure that gets talked into on the third Warcraft, yeah.
Because they kind of showed you the different clans.
Yeah.
And how they're different colored.
Yeah.
You have some that are pale, you have some that are normal, and then you have the green.
Yeah.
And then you have the grayish color.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think a lot of that was like war paint, because it was mainly the red and the green, and then there was those really big guys that were green, but they had a lot of war paint on themselves.
Because mm-hmm. you had the, I mean, and you have all the clans, and they, you can go through that in Warlords of Draenor, as you get to see all the different clans. Mm-hmm. You have Laughing Skull, and the Black Hand.
Wasn't they the Snow Wolves or some shit?
Frost Wolves.
Frost Wolves.
Yeah, that's
that. That entire clan was all still red. Mm-hmm. Because they didn't want to, they didn't like the fell. There's like,
they knew Gul'dan was
out to
not
fuck them
okay
over.
And then he ended up doing that anyways.
Yeah, and that was the big difference between the lore and the movie is Draka and Durotan didn't die separate, and they died together.
Right.
And they were killed by assassins that were supposed to be Doomhammer's guards that
and
turned to be Gul'dan's. Thrall didn't go down a river like Baby Moses.
Well, see, what they do with the movies, they gave it more story and more depth.
Yeah.
They didn't... To me, they didn't ruin it.
They just added what you couldn't have within... They've done really good for compressing a story that's god forever long into a shorter movie.
Plus, they had Blizzard's help, so, I mean,
yeah,
I know
Blizzard's got to give them the okay to do that.
They weren't going to fuck it up too much. Yeah. They had to change a couple of things, but I don't think they did overall too bad, even on the changes that they made.
I was like, the interaction between the characters was really good. And the funny thing is you could actually tell that what's-her-name playing the half-human, half-orc is CGI'd to be larger in every close-up.
Yes.
Yeah, she's supposed to be bigger. Yeah.
Yeah, but it's usually sometimes she was like the same size, depending on the angle. They didn't resize her, unless they were like close up.
I like her tusks. Her tusks were cute.
Her
little nibblers. That's actually the stylized for the trolls are called nibblers. It's adorable. I like it. I think they did really good on her.
Well, see, the deal is, I know orcs came from the other planet.
From Draenor.
But did the trolls...
No. Trolls or Azeroth?
Well, see, that's the deal, is, like, we've never seen anything like you, but I was like, well, the trolls essentially look like skinny orcs.
And short.
Yeah.
They're shorter and skinnier.
No, the trolls were tall.
But they hunched
over. They're hunched over,
but
they're tall.
That's the males. I mean, the females are taller than orcs, too. And that's just the thing of it, they're tall and lanky.
Yeah.
Whereas you have the orcs, they're stout, bulky, and then...
But
yeah, the other ones. And then the Tauren are taller than all of them.
Yeah, and it's like, and the humans, like, well, in the games, they're fucking big. They're almost as big as orcs, but since they're actually using actual people, and when they actually made it to where there was strategy fighting, I was like, okay, that's acceptable.
I was thanking God that they didn't introduce the gnomes.
Gnomes.
Well, there was the dwarves, there was the elves.
Yeah.
And not... We're assuming they were just the high elves because
this
you didn't see
elves.
You didn't see any of the other elves.
Yeah, you didn't.
Because
the
night elves were still there. The blood elves are the ones that actually became a thing from the high elves, and the night elves are all like, "Y'all are douchebags."
Yeah, because the night elves are in their forest.
Mm-hmm.
Same with trolls. Trolls are probably out in the jungles and hiding out.
Yeah,
because
they're in the jungle. They're nowhere near Stormwind or any of that shit.
No, they're on...
So maybe they haven't even seen them.
No.
Not yet. No. Not by that
well,
point.
Also, you got to think, too, of the terrain of the continent where they're at. The humans are on Eastern Kingdoms.
Yeah.
Yeah, but at the same
trolls
time...
Trolls are over at
But
Durotar,
at the same time, when they
Calendar.
Were referencing, they have the map on their roof. It's like, okay, where are you from?
Yeah, well, they do
they
know.
They have it all mapped out, so they would obviously know that if there was, you know, the other races, but the pretty much almost all the Horde, except for the orcs...
Were there. Yeah.
And you saw almost all the Alliance except for the Night Elves.
Yes.
Yeah.
Night Elves and the Gnomes.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the Gnomes. Well... I'm pretty sure if you looked hard enough, you probably would have saw some in the background.
I'm pretty sure at Ironforge, you would have saw them, but not a whole lot. They were the same freaking size as the dwarves. You couldn't really tell.
And I really like the way they actually made the dwarves look.
Like dwarves.
Yeah, I was like, they might have overdid it, but I'd say Ty was closer to the Gabe.
Gave him a finger during the movie.
Mm. He did. He flipped off Ironforge as soon as it popped up.
Ironforge, Stormwind, yeah, fuck them. they got a finger from me.
Fuck
which I was just
places.
Sitting there giddy as a schoolgirl just seeing all this. I'm like, it's my game. Come to life.
It's like, also, if you don't like horses getting killed, they get killed like a motherfucker.
They do.
And pretty brutally half the time.
And used as a weapon.
Yeah. Like true war would happen. Like no
horse. Well,
if
an orc is, you know, the biggest deal is that fucking orc was riding a horse.
Mm-hmm.
I know.
And I was just like, how is that horse even going? And the funny thing is, like,
don't
he's grabbing, like, he's, like, holding the head of the horse.
He's guiding it where he wants to get over here. Go that way.
That was really cool moments. Then the CGI effects were really cool. Like, all the way that they portrayed the magic and...
Yeah, all
the magic was really awesome in this movie.
The only thing I did not like...
And you must see it in 3D.
Which was the teleportation. Because
yeah,
I play a mage.
He plays mage constantly. He's like, that is his number one class.
That's my class. And we don't sparkle when you fucking teleport.
It's like
there's
vampires.
No fucking sparkle. It collapses on it. Collapse on itself.
With no
particles.
Pixie dust afterwards.
Pixie dust.
Pixie dust, whatever. There's none of that bullshit.
Well,
and I didn't like that.
It's like more graphics, man. More graphics. Because
I've watched it in the game, and yeah, it collapses on itself.
He made it a point to sit there and watch people teleport and make portals and all this other crap just to see the effects of, what does this look like whenever I do it? Oh, okay, that's what it looks like.
Yeah, and there's none of that shit. It collapses on itself. Here, there's dust.
It's
fuck
dust.
That shit. I did like, however, the fucking sheep, the polymorph. I was like, fuck yeah!
It's like, it only, you know, the weak-willed or dumb-minded or something. Simple-minded is what it is.
Simple-minded. And that goes true for in the game, because you can only do it on people that are equal level and lower.
If you try to do it on higher level, you were screwed.
You usually got their attention and they come to try to eat your face.
Yeah.
He knows. He did that a lot.
I did that a lot.
It's like, I could polymorph. Oh, no, I can't.
I would have to look at the character that I was trying to polymorph and go, okay, nah, guys, I can't do that. They're too high level.
Mm-hmm.
Well, do it anyway. No. I'll pull that whole fucking mob.
I do not want to have aggro.
Yeah. And granted. So I had to pick and choose who I could do it on. Where, no offense, but thieves could actually...
Rogues,
thieves, they could sap. They could sap pretty much anybody.
Mm-hmm.
Where I couldn't.
He couldn't do a whole lot of crowd control with mage.
No.
And so he got higher level, and then he got the nice, cool shit, and he ended up being... He tried... Oh, God. A little tangent here. I hated raiding with this man, or dungeon delving, for the simple fact that he would play cloth tank as a mage.
Yes.
He would out-aggro the tank constantly, and I'm sitting here looking at him like, are you fucking kidding me? He's like, the tank sucks. And I'm going, you're gonna die. And he's like, no, I'm not.
Doo-doo-doo.
And, yeah.
Pull it out of my ass.
He would pull it out of his ass, and it drove me nuts. Because I play Hunter, so I'm, you know, one of the male-wearing classes. I have a pet.
If I usually said, oops, or uh-oh, everybody's like, oh what the hell.
Shit.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
He's caused many wipes doing that. Yep. He did that just for fun once.
I did that in a raid.
I'm bringing shit with me. They didn't listen.
I feigned death.
Yep. I was like, fuck you guys. Have fun with that.
I did that in a raid whenever they were like, oh, we can handle just about anything. And I was like, guys, I'm bringing shit with me. I'm bringing a lot of shit with me. I'm running. And I got there and everybody wiped. And they were like, how the fuck did we wipe? And I was like, I brought 20 or 30 things with me.
Because he ended up going the wrong way, heading back to where we all were, and pulled what we didn't kill. This is what the importance of clear your area.
And listen to the mage if he's like, I'm bringing shit with me.
Yeah.
I know none of this.
You have to play WoW for a little while.
The closest thing I got to really playing is I played a tank pally. And that was the only time I enjoyed playing, is when they did the random dungeon finder. And then I got bored.
And you got bored. Aww.
Well, it's about like me. For the longest time, remember, I didn't do raids either.
Yeah, this is true. I'm pretty much the one that got to do a whole lot of raids.
Now I have experience in raids, and I know my position and how it works, but it took me a long while. And I still get pissy at the tank. If you don't tank good enough and you don't pull aggro and hold it because my shit's going to go off and I'm going to do a fuck ton of damage because that's what DPS does.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't hold it, it's going to try to eat my face. And so I'm going to do more damage and outdo you.
Oh, yeah.
So it took me a while to get there. And Dungeon Finder, the only thing I didn't like about that is pugging.
Pickup groups.
Yeah, I hated pickup groups, pug groups. Because you get stupid people that don't know their fucking class.
But you got a cool pet if you went on enough and got 100 people, pugged with 100 people, got the perky pug. Okay, yeah, I'll shut up now.
I am not doing that. I am not going to do that.
I was the achievement whore. I liked getting all the vanity pets and the unlocking achievements. And
yeah, I never got a mount.
You never got them? Oh, yeah. Well, now you get a mount at 20.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I never got a mount other than the one that you got issued.
Aw. Sad panda.
Remember? He's going through what I went through.
Touche.
For the longest time, I didn't have the money to get my own mount, except for the one they gave you, and I was like, oh, well, this kind of sucks.
Yeah. But you're caught up. You have warlords now.
That doesn't mean he can't get a fucking mount.
Well, it's not bad. It's just he's still able to play World of Warcraft.
Yeah.
Because up to warlords is what's true. The newest.
Yeah. I don't have any time on my account. I don't ever really plan on playing until they totally change the game because it's too grindy.
Legion.
It is grindy. I give it that.
I like the quests are all the same, just different people.
Yeah, you just can't.
Once you get to a certain point, the grinds become even fucking longer. From 70 to the cap.
Those just going okay for long. Someone that like me and Orgy, where we played nothing but Burning Crusade for years until they came out with Wrath.
Yeah,
Outlands can go eat it whenever it comes to leveling up because there's no when you get to the Outlands, there's no special level through to go fast. There's no. None of that. You have to grind through Outlands like you did the last time.
Yeah,
which is stupid. They need to fix it. Same with Northrend. Slow. There's no real quickie to Northrend either.
I don't know. You can speed through it. I felt that the grind for Outlands sucked a nut because it was slow.
Yeah.
Northrend was pretty fast. It depends on which route you take because you're at a fork. Mm. And you can go this route or that route. And both routes are not that
far
long
from each other.
Yeah.
Pandaria can go eat a dick.
Well, Pandaria's not really all that hard to level through.
No, it's not hard to level through, but it's fucking long.
Yeah, this is true.
Then you got the whole,
Warlords.
No. The where you,
Well, Cataclysm was before Pandaria.
What's the name of it?
Which is
where all the mummies are at and the pyramids. The half... They look like a horse people.
Centaurus?
Oh!
What the hell name is it? I used to have...
That was Cataclysm. You're talking about Uldum.
Yeah, Uldum is not that bad. But
that's,
you still had that
content.
Area.
Yeah.
But it's pretty lengthy. But it's not that bad, but it's pretty lengthy. You got to go here to go there to go... It's the same shit, but it's not as long. Where the rest of that, it's pretty fucking lengthy.
I mean, even now that they've fixed it where you don't have to grind out quests, you can just go through dungeons and raids and level.
Yeah, which is the reason why I started to play when they put in the random... I was playing right before they put in the random Dungeon Fighter.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, and then I was able to play, but then I was like, no one to play with.
Yeah.
And everyone else was on a different server. And then I went on there and I was like, I'm not starting.
Well, I showed her that in the game, when you take a character and you strictly quest with it, it takes you not a long time, but it's pretty grindy. Where if you dungeon as soon as you can and you stick with it, you'll outdo the people that are questing.
Yeah, well, which is what happened with me, but then I had no idea where I was supposed to go next.
But you're not going
to
get the same gear as you were if you were to go questing.
I quit. The only reason why I quest and I don't do dungeons and raids to level is because I like the lore.
Right.
You yeah, but the lore is so hard to fucking follow because it's so dry. It's very...
You gotta know the right people to go to, and I get that.
Yeah.
You
like,
do.
It's really dry. Like, you're like, oh, you're doing this. I'm like, why are we doing this?
See, what I would do is... That's why I would level so quickly is because I would go through the dungeons get my levels, come out, do one or two quests, pick up my gear, and go right back. Yeah. Because of the gear that I missed from the quest part. And I would get new gear, quickly get geared up, make sure I got all my pieces, go right back to dungeoning.
But even now they have XP bonuses to where it doesn't matter if you're questing or you're dungeoning, you're going to level pretty quickly.
Yeah.
Now, but like the story's dry. It's like if they did something like Guild Wars 2.
How do you mean?
The story, you could just play the game and level without having to really grind at any point. Like, you still have the random, like, you gotta go do this, but they also had events where something would happen at random times of the day, and those were fun because you gotta do it with a bunch of other people all at the same time. Well, WoW doesn't have anything like that.
Yeah.
Well, they do, but it's called the world bosses.
Wow.
Yeah, you have world bosses, like,
Got to show up, and you got to...
Doomlord Kozak and all those, and you have to go find them.
But you got to know what they are.
Yeah.
Because if you just show up in the middle of a map, you're not going to know, hey, this world boss is sitting right over there. Remember, I don't even know all that fucking shit. And you would be like, hey, this person's up. And I'm like...
Who? Where?
Okay. Yeah. And then you wouldn't be even able to help. Or Guild Wars, you could literally... not be quite that level and still be able to contribute in some way or form.
Mm-hmm.
And also with WoW, it's like you have to have people to play with, or it's just not enjoyable, at least not for me.
A lot of people, that was what it was for them, is they didn't enjoy it by themselves. Where I'm weird that way. I can either raid with our friends, or I can just go on solo and
I had my own account, I was always on somebody else's account.
And he didn't get to raid a whole lot.
I didn't have the luxury of having friends.
I understand that. The hand members would get together and raid and all that. Orgy wasn't able to because he was on Darren's account or somebody else's account. Yeah.
And I'd get booted off so they could go raid. And I'm like, well, that
the one time that
sucks.
He got to play WoW a whole lot was whenever I left my laptop with him while he was living at Big Chris's, because I went to a furry convention.
Mm-hmm. So for a week, I got to play.
I was like,
but
you get to babysit my laptop in my car. Have fun.
But at that point, even then, I didn't have the friends, and I had to take that character and go make friends.
Yeah.
And then
hope to God that they weren't going to pug fuck me.
Yeah, and then there was the whole...
Or loot raid.
There was no local... Well, there was local chat, but it was typing, and I hate typing.
Yeah.
There was no voice acting in the game.
There was voicing, but it was shitty.
It was
you
shitty.
You had to have Ventrilo or Curse or something to talk with, or TeamSpeak.
Yeah, so I was saying, you had to have that, or there was no way of communicating, but for Curse to work, you have to have people that you know.
Yeah. Which I can see where that aspect is.
See, and where I did a lot of the texting, that's how I went through a lot of shit.
Oh, yeah. I know I'm getting, like, zoned out, guys, sorry. I mentioned the hand. That's the Amp Guard fighting company that... Valance and I are in. Orgy helped found that one.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, now we're gonna go back on to the movie.
Yeah, like I was trying to say. You should go watch it in 3D because the magic is amazing.
It is.
Yeah, it is worth it in 3D.
The effects. Mm-hmm. There's only like certain times where even on any 3D movies when stuff goes across the screen like really fast and up close, it's a little choppy. But other than that.
Yeah, it's not bad.
It's really spiffy.
I have to agree with Valance. There's times where it is choppy. The up close and in the center, oh, dude, it's pretty epic.
Mm-hmm.
You got shit flying at your face. It's kind of cool.
Okay, I know I mentioned Orgy earlier today before we even went to go see the movie. We weren't going to pick favorites and hates.
Yeah.
But we're going to pick favorites and hates. And we're going to do this on the spot, not even rehearsed, nothing, don't have lists or nada.
Awesome.
So, yeah, so we're going to do who's your favorite. We're going to go around here. So, Orgy, you start off. Who is your favorite?
My favorite?
Mm-hmm.
I got to say Durotan.
Durotan? Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. Got to love Thrall's papa.
Yeah. the portrayal of Durotan, he was fucking awesome.
It was pretty good. And the character.
Yeah.
And especially when he freaking... What was that? Doomhammer. He punches him in the stomach. And then, like, knocks him down like, you dick. Yeah, it's like, why did you betray? It's like, I didn't know, my bad, bro.
Yeah.
And then gives him the hand back up that's really a firm grasp.
Mm-hmm. See, I liked the beginning interaction between him and Draka, how she's like, yeah. He goes, can you hide your fat belly? And she punches him in the arm. That's just really hilarious.
Yeah, the whole, was like,
can you hide your fat head?
Yeah, more than you can hide your fat head.
The fact that the characters had, well, character.
And they, yeah, and they showed emotions.
Yeah. A lot of emotions. You could tell that Draka and Durotan were in love. You can tell that Durotan felt
betrayal.
Well,
it's betrayal. Like, well, they do the facial capture, but only like, well, see what they did with facial capture in this movie is they didn't actually base it off of the fucking people that were voice acting them.
No.
No.
Like they normally do in most movies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They actually got people to do the reactions.
And like, essentially, they'll use the markers on their head with their fucking weird ass head apparatus.
Mm-hmm.
That essentially just records their heads. Yeah. You know, which probably one of the coolest things I've seen.
So, who was your favorite?
Who's your favorite, Valance?
Well, you know, the guy, the main guy.
Lothar? The human, or?
The human.
The human, okay. And he was the warrior that kept...
Yeah, yeah. Drunk.
Lothar. Okay, you liked Lothar. Alright.
Well, because he's also the main character for fucking Vikings. And it took me a minute to realize it, because I was like, that fucking hair piece he has on his head, just, it does not look like his hair, because it's really not.
No.
And you could, like, just, I couldn't stop staring at his hair. I was like, they could have just kept him with his hair in the fucking Vikings, because he's still doing that while he did that.
Yeah. He just kind of was, he was doing them both at the same time, wasn't he?
Mm-hmm. Pretty much. And that's one of the reasons why they chose him for, like, a lot of the action scenes, because he's doing that in another series.
Yeah. This is true. So he did really good.
Wait, isn't he becoming, like, isn't he the Lich King?
No, Arthas becomes the Lich King.
Arthas appears to become the Lich King.
Yeah. Arthas is the one that becomes Lich King. Right now, Arthas is a child.
Yeah, but isn't he, like, the guy that confronts him?
No.
Isn't he the old dude?
No. Lothar dies.
Yeah.
Later on, spoiler.
We covered this on the way home.
Yeah, Lothar dies later on, and then Varian... Rin becomes the next king. The little kid that they
the
were like...
The little kid that they were referencing to?
Yeah,
yeah, but
Blaine was
where
like...
Where did the storyline?
Warcraft 3, if you want to go by RTS.
Okay.
Way later does Arthas go get Shadowmourne and all that fun jazz. So, I mean, it's like way... Because
when Arthas becomes a Lich King, he's in... He's either 20s going into his 30s or 30s going into his 40s.
Yeah.
He's not an old man.
Yeah, but isn't
he
trying to stop him?
No.
Doesn't he?
No. Lothar doesn't play a big part later on. He just becomes very old and dies. Lives a good valid life, and then his nephew Varian becomes king.
Mm-hmm.
Well, because essentially they're going to go into the second game.
Yeah.
So who was your favorite, Z?
Okay, my favorite was Garona. I really liked Garona. It was a tie between Draka and Garona. Because, yeah, I love Thrall's mom really a lot, especially in the game.
Yeah.
But even more so in the movie now, because it held true to her.
Yeah.
Now, it showed, because I'm a big orc fanatic, even though I play mostly Blood Elves, I love orcs. But
I hate orcs.
I love orcs.
And I like orcs.
You're the weird one.
I hate orcs.
But,
they're oversized. That was the reason why I didn't really like the Hordos. I was like, they're so fucking huge. Like,
yeah.
If they were just, like, half that size, I'd be totally fine with the orcs. But to me, they were just oversized. In the movie, like, the way they're actually portrayed, I think was awesome. But, like, in the game, the reason why I didn't like the orcs is, like, I didn't like the model.
Yeah. And they've updated all the models, too.
Well, they're still huge. They look better, but they're still the same thing.
True. But, I liked Draka, and I liked Garona. And
did I even talk about that? Yeah, I did.
Yeah, you did.
Never mind.
I really...
The combat part?
Garona. Yeah, Garona, I like her in the games, because she's, like, that roguey assassin.
Yeah, yeah.
She was half-orc, after... half-orc, after nigh. And her name is half-orcan. So, which is... Yeah.
Right.
Funny, ha-ha. Yeah. But...
In the movie, her name is cursed.
Yeah.
It's what it translates. Well, that's what Garona translated to in orc, was cursed. The cursed one.
Isn't Zug Zug like hi or yes?
It's a confirmation.
So yes.
So yes. Zug, zug. And then Luktar Ogar is victory or death.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, so the two Orc females that had big parts in the movie were my favorites.
Just still really digging on the magic in the movie.
You're still having nerdgasm over there on the magic.
Yeah, it looked really awesome.
It did. I'm not gonna lie, it really did.
I was like, especially like when they just like pinned what's his name against the wall, and then
Khadgar.
I was like, the way it looked.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, the magic animation in the movie was like probably the best I've seen in any movie.
Yeah, oh, I have to agree.
Oh yeah.
I was like, and then seeing it in 3D just made it even better.
Oh yeah.
Especially in the end credit deal, the fucking. I was just like, I just want to watch this. This is
cool. And there was only two wargs in that movie. The Black Hand was riding one. He was riding the brown.
No, there was more than two.
Well, they focused on two.
There was three that you could see almost every other.
Three or four.
Because there was the white one, there was a gray one, and then there was a brown one. Okay, you didn't see very much of the brown one.
No, because that's Black Hand's wolf.
No, you didn't see much of the brown one.
Yeah, and then there was the white one, which was Duratan's. Uh-huh. White-gray, it was a white-gray one.
And the one that he was protecting, or had the sword against his throat.
Yeah, that was when Doomhammer rode after him. Mm-hmm. So that was Doomhammer's warg, I believe.
Yeah, the one that looked like a...
There was a brief black one.
Mm-hmm. Was there a brief black one? Okay, so there was...
When they're on the hill?
Yeah, when he howls, when the wolf howls...
Oh,
there's a black one that rides off.
Yeah, and there's actually a fuck ton of them. Like when
in
they're
the
on
scene,
top of it.
Yeah, when you're looking down at the village getting ransacked.
Yeah, there's a good amount of
them. That was another thing I liked about the movie is the overview. It made it look like an RTS.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was just like because you would see one town, you would see like if you really paid attention, you actually see the individual people fighting.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And the battle scene.
I didn't get it for a minute.
What?
That whole... Yeah, I know Orky's looking at me like I'm crazy, but...
The whole overview
of them going from each town, I was like, what the hell is going on? And, okay, now I understand. That's RTS.
They were raiding.
The RTS thing.
Yeah,
was the orcs raiding all the places. They took that town, they took that town, and then they turned Stonewatch or Stone Tower or whatever. Mm-hmm. Was that very last deal.
Yeah.
And that was actually a campaign in the RTS. Was
nice.
To take down that tower.
Oh, cool.
That entire section was campaign.
That's why I'm looking at you strangely, because they were talking about them invading the garrisons.
Yeah.
That's the lead, that very end one,
uh-huh.
was the garrison.
Oh.
That's the towns, all the human towns in between that.
Oh. Fair
all enough. Those people that were in cages were all the humans that they had captured. That's why they were so, that's why the king showed up. To get all those people, because that's the people that they had gotten
and then
captured.
And then when they're fighting over the gate, it goes into the third person, and it looked like a really, really fancy RTS.
Yes.
Huh, fair enough.
Thank
See,
you.
The things yeah, that I
high five.
High five, because we both caught that
there
one. I was
you
like,
go.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay, fair enough. But I know, like.
In case you didn't know what RTS means, real time strategy.
Yes.
Yes.
There's that one. And I know.
Strategy games. I like strategy.
Like a lot of people that played World of Warcraft and Warcraft and all that, mm-hmm. they know Garam Hellscream.
Yep.
And I was constantly like, oh god, there he is. Oh god, there he is. Because I really liked Garam.
You didn't hear him speak
he
a whole lot.
He never spoke.
But
he didn't have any lines at all.
You could see him in the background. You can, if you know the weapons that people used, you got to see that axe.
Mm-hmm.
I can't
spot
that
as soon as you see that
axe,
you're like, oh, there's Gorhel. Oh, there is... Hellscream.
Yep.
Sweet.
The
and
red
I really
guy.
Like that one.
The red guy that was holding the axe.
Yeah, that was Hellscream.
That's Hellscream.
He later on in Warcraft 3 is the one that goes with Thrall and beats the big demon thing to free them from the fell blood and all that. Free the orcs from the blood curse. And...
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the thing, the reason why I don't think that he was shown that much because it wasn't focused mainly on Hellscream.
No, it was all Durotan.
And
Gul'dan and Doomhammer and
Black they're the
Hand.
Reddish ones. That's
Doomhammer just smashing people in the face.
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah.
He just liked to hit people in the face.
Like, they're like, oh, go get him. No, get out of here.
But the only thing that's going to be weird is how they're going to portray the orcs going to Alterac Valley and Alterac Mountains because...
What?
That's Alterac Mountains is where the Frost Wolf Clan end up going.
The mountains that were off to the right.
Yeah.
You have the snowy ones over here. Then you have the other mountain range. And then you have the valley. Uh-huh. That mountain range is supposed to be Alteric Mountains.
And that's where they end up going because it felt more like home to them.
Right.
And yeah. That's where they set up their base. And then you have the battle for Alteric Valley between the Dunmorrow and the...
Yeah, because that's when they're going to hit into the giants and shit.
And the ogres and all that. Yeah. And it's going to be weird because that's where Durotan and Draco go to.
Right.
To set up the Frostwolf clan. But now that in the movie they're dead, it's kind of like, well, uh-oh. How are they going to fix that in the lore?
Well, probably... Well, they since might have, Doomhammer is...
Might have Ogrim do it. Because Ogrim is the one that teaches Thrall.
Yeah, because like... Because Doomhammer is part of that same clan, so he yes. might actually end up setting it up.
Good possibility. And he is actually the one that ends up being the main guy, at least in World of Warcraft. He's the one that's there.
And currently, by the movie standards, there's no magic users except for Gul'dan on the orc side at all.
Yeah. Like, they didn't even touch the shamans. Mm-hmm. They didn't touch the warlocks.
Oh, the reason why is because, like, the way the movie goes, they didn't have anyone powerful enough to go up because they didn't have any wizards, so they had to essentially try to recruit the humans because they had wizards because they saw that shit.
Right. Because if they had the magic users, then most of them wouldn't have died.
True. This is true. They hadn't taught there were no shamans or anything.
Well, the shamans came from the fucking trolls.
Yes, no. There were shamans in the Frostwolf clan and everything before that happened. I think it's mainly because with Warcraft orcs versus humans, there wasn't shamans.
They may be getting pushed to the Alteric Mountains by the movie standards because there's really nowhere for them to set up because if they set up where they were at, humans are going to constantly attack.
Mm, true.
And Gul'dan's going to go one way. They may have to get shoved to the Alteric Mountains.
Yeah. Touché. And I think mostly, too, is that they're going to have to do the blood curse and, you know, Garam drinking from the skull of, and all that, doing all that.
And see, and I think that's
what will start unlocking the shamans.
That's maybe where
it
gets split.
Oh, no. No, no, no. The Tarn are what kind of help Thrall learn to become a shaman.
Yeah.
That's it. Yeah. And then you start having the shamans coming in more and more. Because the Tarn were more of the shamanistic.
Yeah.
The troll were more of shadow hunters and axe throwers and voodoo. You'll come get the voodoo. I had to do that once. Get off me. Just once.
But yeah, I could see them doing that by movie standards. Getting shoved over there towards the Alteric Mountains because there's nothing the humans know about it, but
now the humans know, hey, there's
you shove them that way and Gul'dan can go off and do his own fucking thing.
Yeah, fair enough. I can't wait till they show Karen and Bane and all them, the Tarn.
Yeah,
and the trolls.
That's probably going to be coming later.
The second one, third one, maybe. I do hope they continue with these.
I hope so too.
Actually, the one thing I've been sitting here just thinking about is StarCraft. Because I know more about StarCraft than I actually know about Warcraft.
I don't know a damn thing about StarCraft.
But I can tell you right now, it's just like, I would play a fucking StarCraft, like, MMO.
Fair enough.
I was like, especially considering they could actually do it completely different than WoW. Because WoW, at this point, the only reason why they really haven't changed the formula is because they have all the dedicated people still.
Mm-hmm.
And they try to change it even a little bit, and they're like, ah! And it's like, ah!
See, it would be kind of cool if they introduced a StarCraft movie, because with everybody liking the Aliens versus Predators kind of thing, it could lead right into StarCraft.
I have no knowledge whatsoever of StarCraft.
We do.
I just know Kerrigan is one badass chick. That's about it.
I was just like, about StarCraft is the story was way better than Warcraft.
Yeah.
Like, it was more in-depth, and you could actually follow everything that was going on because the way they portrayed everything. And
all the races. How they interact and everything.
And I was like, and since they did this movie, I could totally see them doing a StarCraft movie and making it amazing.
What do you think about doing a Diablo movie?
I was like, a Diablo movie they could have done that years ago and still been awesome. If they did it now, it'd still be fucking cool and I'd go different. Watch it.
I would too.
It's like, the only deal with that is you don't really have a main protagonist. Like, you don't have a main character.
Oh, this is true. Because
there's several different characters, and you are that person. And essentially, they would have to choose from, like, five different characters.
Or have a whole group of characters.
But to give them all justice, they'd have to go really in-depth.
Yeah.
Like, each, like, chapter would be a movie.
Ah, true.
I mean, they could make, what, 1, 2, 3, 4 times 6. They could make 20 movies just off fucking Diablo.
Good.
Based off the chapters and, like, all the shit that goes on.
Because then that would go from not just Diablo 3, it'd be 1, 2, and 3.
Yeah, and each one of them.
No, they would have to skip 2.
Why would they have to skip 2?
Because 2 was a different perspective, and it's way different from 1 and 3.
It didn't continue the lore?
It did, but not really.
It's like
it was its own separate entity. It was the first time it introduced MMO to Diablo.
Yeah, Diablo 1
was...
Diablo 2 and Diablo 1, almost, they're kind of the same game.
Right.
Just revamped.
Yeah.
Gotcha. I'd never played Diablo 1 and 2.
If they did 2 and 1, and, like, was there, like, 6 chapters per game?
Yeah.
That was, like, 12 movies. And, like, each chapter could be its own movie if they fucking put, like, all the depth in the character, like, and all the little shit that you can learn.
And you would have to take out, like, Barbarian. Well, not, you wouldn't have to take it out, but Druid and Necromancer.
Mm.
They exist in 2, which they don't exist in 1 and 3.
No. Fair enough.
But they could also introduce it later on in the movies.
Because they would have to touch up on Barbarian because of the mountain.
Well, like, because in the second one, it's fucking, there's...
At least in the third one. But.
You have the Paladin, you have the Rogue, you have... What is it? The Sorcerers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Essentially, the followers you have in the third one, or the characters that you played in the second one?
Mm-hmm.
But were the classes for the second one.
Templar,
not those.
Rogue, and, yeah, Sorceress.
Yeah.
Or Temptress.
No, it was Paladin. It wasn't Templar. Templar is one you can play in the third one.
No, Crusader you can play in the third one. He's called Templar in the third one.
He's called a Paladin.
Templar.
Well, he's a Paladin in the second one.
Okay.
But he had the same freaking Holy Crusade bullshit.
Right. Okay, so we got our favorites and gone a little bit off here, but who we hated in the movie. If we even had hated one, so... Orgy, did you have someone you hated?
Someone hated or something?
Someone, something... or like it, character-wise. Someone you didn't like.
I didn't like the Alliance King.
Yeah.
Lane?
Yeah.
He was pretty lame.
Lane was lame, okay.
Like...
Was that who you didn't like too?
Yeah, in all honesty, like, he had the least... less... His character had no character, really.
Yeah, that's
like,
what
it
I
was
just
very, very bland. And it wasn't until the very end, like, where he's like, kill me. And I was like, that was the only time he had some kind of character. Before, it was just like, He could have just mumbled, and it would have been the same results. And the actor they had him play was very... He didn't portray, like, a strong king. He looked like the prince.
Yeah, yeah. That's what I was just fixing to say. He seemed like he was...
not the leader of the fucking Stormwind.
The humans.
You're the alliance.
I was just
you're
like,
the
no,
alliance
no.
King. You should be king. And he seemed like he was being...
That and he let his council push him
rule
over.
Him. Yeah.
Because he wasn't actually the king of the council. He was king of Stormwind. That was it. They had a council. He wasn't at the fucking seat. It was fucking just round.
Oh, that's true.
And they were all just talking to each other like fucking equals. There was no... point of power on anything.
True.
Because I think at this point, because the way everyone was acting is they had an alliance, yes, but there was no structure. It was just like, all right, we're not warring anymore. They had a council with no seat of the head. And I think since at the very end of the movie, they go, yeah, we want you to be the leader. And he's like, all right, and grabs the sword. Woo! Now he's the leader.
Mm-hmm.
And then that's where they were like, and now we're the alliance.
Yeah. I was getting ready to be so pissed off. I was with Shotgun on that one, that if they would have ended the movie with
without
them all
the
saying,
baby.
For the Alliance, I would have been pissed.
The movie would have gave, I would have gave it a finger.
Yeah. I've been like, fuck this, fuck that ending, but they redeemed it by going to Baby Thrall. I was like, there's my baby war chief. I was happy. Or baby chieftain. Yay.
So who did you not like?
The Queen. I can't remember her name either. I didn't like her because, I mean, it seemed like they were trying to make her a major role, but lacking in a sense.
She had more character because she went up to what's-her-face.
Garona.
In the cage and actually just went, it's like, you can kill me, but I don't really give a damn.
Yeah, here's some shit that you may need to survive. I don't care if you kill me, whatever.
I didn't really like it because she... I
can tell you one thing. I don't think they should have chose her as the queen. That particular actor. It was just like...
She looked like she was missing a set of balls.
She looked like she was the servant.
Yeah.
Not the queen. She looked... for the longest time, I thought she was the servant until she went... until it was like, that's your mate? Like, no, I'm the king's mate. I'm like...
That's my brother. Oh, yeah.
I'm like... Oh, I thought she was fucking, like, maiden. Like, you know, servant to the queen.
Yeah,
I was like,
that's
what
that was the problem that I had, is that she didn't really have much of a character. Like, you didn't know who she was right off the bat, for one. That, and she seemed to be poking her nose in business she shouldn't have. Two. Three, she didn't really fit all too well in my book. Lane is a given, because, well, Lane didn't really have big much part in Warcraft anyway, but
what
other than dying and paving the way for Lorthar to get
Lane,
the guy that y'all don't like.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Alright. I was just like,
I know names are escaping you.
I was like, I hear these names, and then
plus
like,
I didn't like his helm either.
Oh, the lion's helmet.
Well,
it didn't even look like a lion's helmet.
That's what it was supposed to be. It was supposed to be a lion's helmet.
Well, the deal with that entire movie is all their armor is fucking cosplay armor, essentially. It's all like EVA fucking foam. They had essentially people that make cosplay armor.
Mm-hmm.
That's what their armor was. Like, you could definitely tell. I was just looking. I was like, that literally looks like cosplay armor. Like Plasti-Dip and EVA foam. I was like, there was only certain moments where the things were made out of metal.
See, like Durotan's helm?
It looked like plastic.
To me, it looked like his actual wolf head.
Oh, yeah, Durotan's helm, yeah.
The Alliance guy? No.
He had an actual helmet, and
it looked
it
like a cat.
Meow.
It was, like, placed up against his face, and I'm like, no. If you're going to wear a lion's head, wear a goddamn lion's head.
Yeah, they should have made it more, like...
profound with the mane, at least.
Yeah, it was very low-key. Essentially, they had someone make it for them, because...
It looked like a pug-nosed lion.
It was very form-fitted. And yeah, it's like, what I did really like is all the Alliance soldiers had the armor the way it looks more or less in the game.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, see, I did like that.
That was cool.
It's just his helm. I was like,
and what I liked is that almost none of that was CGI for the armor. That was all...
They were in the armor.
They were in cosplay armor.
I bet they didn't. I bet they were hot as hell, too.
No, you could tell that shit wasn't very hot. Mm. It was very loose and bouncy on them. That's the reason why I was just like that. None of that. It's even metal, except for like maybe the shield might be metal, but I'm pretty sure it's molded plastic.
Says that he does a lot of the cosplay replica and weapons and everything, so he knows pretty good on that stuff. How to make, how to do.
I was just like, I mean, the leather armor, that was the most authentic thing that they were wearing when they weren't wearing their plate and they were scouting.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, I actually liked the fact that they weren't wearing their armor.
Plate.
Because that's more tactical, for one, and two, it was actually leather armor.
See, and I like the orcs, like the one guy who wore the spine down his back.
Yeah.
As armor.
And then it fused to him after he got the fucking...
The fell.
Fell on him, and then fused his head to where it was... I was like, because I was like, I saw it when I was like, you will be the... I was like, how much you want to bet that's going to fuse to him? And then... Yeah. And it was really funny because I was like, how much you want to bet a tongue's going to be hanging out of it? And there's a tongue hanging out of one of the mouths on his shoulder.
Yep. That's awesome.
And I was just like,
I didn't even catch that.
I did. It, like, there was a close up and you're going like this and there's a tongue hanging out. And I'm like, okay.
Okay. I really liked Gul'dan's look, though. They did really good with Gul'dan. He looked just like how he does in all the cinematics for Warcraft, or the World of Warcraft things, and then his, when he took off his robe, usually to me, I thought that, like, that was on part of the robe. I didn't think those were freaking spiked bones from off of
his
body.
Because he's corrupted.
Yeah.
I didn't like the fact that they made him look huge.
Mm-hmm.
Where everybody else that gets the fell, they become like withered.
Like he was like when he was wearing his outfit, he's fucking withered and hunched. But apparently, because when he's wearing all his robes and stuff, he was hunched over. But yet, essentially, when he took off all his clothes, he unhunched over, and then you realize how big he really is.
Yeah.
He's not as big as all the other ones, but he was the big same girl. Size as fucking fuckface that died.
Durotan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I did not like the fact that, I mean, everybody else that gets the fell in the movie becomes withered.
Yeah.
He did not.
Yeah.
Once he took off his robes, that motherfucker's pretty Arnold Schwarzenegger built. I was like,
it's like, I mean, that's he was leaky, like in the forearms and like the legs and stuff, but his torso was, yeah, pretty stout.
Fucking huge.
I did like how they
I think that's just the anatomy of the orcs, and they were just trying to keep with that.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, I think they were trying to surprise everyone. It's like, yeah, he's not just withered.
I really like how they all kept to the fact that orcs are very traditional and honor-bound, and whenever he was starting to cheat, they were like, he's cheating!
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, that was probably my favorite part, and cheater. Also the part that pissed me off the most. Because none of the red orcs, except for one guy, was there, and there was a lot of them, but they killed pretty much almost all the red orcs because they were like, no, the freaking...
They're weak.
The Snow Wolves, or whatever.
Frost Wolf Clan
is traitor, and we have to go get them.
Mm-hmm.
Hell, even the Laughing Skull was like, you cheater.
Yeah, and Laughing Skull usually doesn't care.
They don't give a shit.
They're maniacal in their own sense. But, okay, we're going to wrap this one up, guys. So, y'all suggest watching the movie?
Oh, yeah, go watch it. It's awesome.
Watch it in 3D if you can.
Oh, yeah.
That's
gives
it
even
Lance.
More epic.
Yep.
We definitely give it at least thumbs up. I give it 2 thumbs up because, well, I'm a nerd.
I'm a nerd. 2 thumbs
like,
up.
It was like, out of 10, I would say at least. There's only one thing that bothers me. I would give it a 10, and that's some of the CGI with the squishy head part, with the breaking the neck. But other than that, yeah, I would give it a 10.
All right. So I got good reviews on this one, guys. That was Warcraft and all of our little knowledge of all the games and other games that go with it. So... Yeah, I think we all pretty much enjoyed watching that movie.
Yeah.
StarCraft movie.
Mm.
Well, it's an Orgy say StarCraft movie. Apparently, I need to get caught up on StarCraft lore and everything. Figure out what in the world.
Good.
I know it's an RTS, but that's about as far as my knowledge goes with that.
I played StarCraft and 2.
Mm.
The newest one's pretty good, too.
I haven't played the newest one.
But I haven't played the expansions.
No, neither have I.
Fair enough. So, yeah, I think we're going to wrap this little special up. It's not... I know it didn't post on Friday because, well, we were too excited, wanted to get this out and going for you guys.
Right.
But we'll have an episode Friday and every mm-hmm. Friday. We have a new email because I got off my butt and made a new email for us. So nocturnalnerds.podcast@gmail.com. I'll put the link down below. I'm also going to put a link to RattlesTV and to Lancer Armory as well.
Meh.
Just RattlesTV.
It's like, I don't do anything with Lancer Armory except for make Amgard weapons. I was like, I eventually plan on making more than that, but right now, not really.
Well, it'll get you people looking at least. Uh-huh. No hurt in trying. But thanks, guys, for listening to us ramble on for an hour here.
Yes, thank you.
Our longest show yet. And thanks, Lance, for, you know, coming and joining us with this. And
Thank you.
Thank you for, you know, buying the tickets for us and let us go with you.
Yes.
Because that was awesome.
That was awesome.
But... So, yep, tune in Fridays, guys, and we will see... Well, not see. Dang it!
Ha ha!
Did it again!
Ha ha!
Stuck on the movies. Yeah.
Hear from you again, yeah.
Yeah. Anyways, guys. Ja matane.
Laters, guys.
You know, go away.